In the last module, we discussed what is the purpose of life. So today we will discuss how to set goals in our life and how to achieve these goals or aims in our life. In your young age, you should set goals or aims in your life. All of you might have read our former president APJ Abdul Kalam's Wings of Fire. So in that book, he says about the importance of setting goals or objectives in life. You should have an aim in your life. You should desire to fulfill that aim in your life. So this is what he says. First, set goal in your life. Then you should have an intense desire to fulfill this aim. Then only you will work hard. So set goals, then desire to achieve that goal, then work hard to achieve that goal. So that is why he said, you have the wings of fire. So work hard to achieve the set goals and objectives in your life. So in order to achieve your aim, you should remember certain things. The first and foremost thing is value of time. Time and tide wait for none. This is a very common proverb you might have heard. So there is no need to postpone things. There is no need to wait for the best time. So do things at the right time. So value of time is an important thing to achieve our goals and aims in life. Next is the influence of example. So there are many people around us who lead us, who guide us with the examples of their life. Our parents, our teachers, and many people, many great people around us. So they have set their life as an example for us. So let us be influenced by these examples around us. So here, there are some examples of people who lived with purpose. Mahatma Gandhi, Mother Teresa, who is known as the Apostle of Love, APJ Abdul Kalam, who inspired us a lot. Success is in perseverance. So you should have that determination to achieve your goals in life. So there is no other easy way to success. Work hard, have strong determination that will lead you to success. So as young students, this is the right time for you to work hard and you will get the fruit of it later. So don't waste time. Work hard to achieve your aims and ambitions and goals in life. Pleasure of working and obligation of duty. Enjoy working and be obliged towards your duty. Have that sense of obligation towards duty. Simplicity in life is another way to achieve our aim in life. So learn that dignity of simplicity and also have the wisdom of economy. Learn the virtue of patience. Be patient while doing things. That is also a way to achieve our aim in life. Worth of character and improvement of talent. These two are also essential in order to achieve our aim in life. Let others talk good about you. And also try to find out your talents and improve those talents. Power of kindness. Be kind towards others. That is also a step to achieve your aim.
So
these are some of the ways to achieve aims in life or objectives in life. And let us listen to a few inspirational words of Dr. APJ.
Or you want to become a doctor?
My ambition is to become, I want to study more on aerospace engineering.
Yes. You are become a life scientist, right?
Yes.
Very good girl, okay. Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
Okay.
So my question to you is, a journey from Rameshwaram to Rashtrapati Bhavan is indeed a great achievement which no one can think of.
You are giving a lecture now, what's the question?
Sir, I would like to hear from you a few tips for the upcoming generation to succeed in life.
Well, succeeding life, I have already told you.
Yes, sir.
You have to do four things, okay? Number one, repeat with me. Number one, you repeat.
Number one.
Great aim.
Great aim.
I will have great aim.
I will have great aim.
I will continuously acquire knowledge.
Continuously acquire knowledge.
Oh, I will do hard work.
I will do hard work.
I will persevere.
I will persevere.
And succeed.
And succeed.
Okay, that's the mantra.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Okay. You can go. Yes. That's all. Nobody else. Stop. Okay.
Sir,
go ahead.
Sir, I am Jobin. I study in 7th standard from Concordia UBS Perurkada. My question, at present, what are the major strengths and weakness of our
India? Your mic, can you keep the mic like this? Like this. Keep distance. Slowly speak. Speak now. You are a good fellow. Yes.
Sir, I am poor English. Study in Malayalam medium.
Malayalathil parai.
At present, what are the major strengths and weakness of our India?
What are the?
Major strength.
What are the major strength of India?
And weakness of our India.
And weakness, fantastic boy. What class you are studying?
Seventh standard.
Okay. Now, strength of India. What the major strength of India? You guys, that is 600 million youth. Major strength of India, 600 million youth. Okay?
Okay.
So the youth, repeat with me, ignited mind. All of you, ignited mind.
Ignited mind.
Of the youth.
Of the youth.
Is the most powerful resource.
This is what?
On the earth.
On the earth.
Above the earth.
Above the earth.
Under the earth.
Under the earth.
You said, what is the weakness of India? Weakness of India. What is the weakness of India? Weakness of India, without vision, a nation dies without vision. You must have a vision, okay? Great vision.
Thank you, sir.
Great vision. You can go. Again, addition. I will answer only 5 more guys, okay.
Good evening, sir. I am Krishnidu KB, representing Sri Vivekananda Memorial Public School. Let me put forth my question.
Your mic, you are putting in your mouth, will distance. Yes.
Among all your valuable accomplishments, which did you consider as outstanding as a space scientist and as a president of India?
Well, I personally believe I always value as a teacher, I'm a teacher. When my student got a PhD, that was the greatest happiness for me. Okay. Next year. You can go.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Give the mic and go. What's your name?
Vishnu Dinagajit.
Which class you are studying?
Fifth.
What is your dream?
My dream is to become an IAS officer.
IAS officer. Okay. Tell me, you are a smart fellow. You are a smart boy. As an IAS, when you become an IAS fellow, what will you do to the country?
I
You say what I'm saying, okay? As an IAS officer, repeat with me, as an
IAS officer,
I will remove the corruption. Okay, now what's your question?
My question is that, sir, can you say a few words to the new generation who are ignorant of the human values like love, compassion and gratitude?
Can you say a few words on love, compassion and gratitude? Okay. Now, love emanates from parents, you know, that cannot be valued. No value. It may be millions of rupees also you cannot buy. It comes from parent, father, mother. Okay. That's why today you took a oath. What is the oath you took? I will make my mother happy, you are taken. So that's why you are gratitude, because of the love. Compassion, we have to have. Today I saw when I was traveling, a father, mother, two physically challenged children, they cannot talk to each other. But when they entered the aircraft, the whole aircraft passenger, everyone was showing the love and affection, compassion to the two children who are physically challenged. That's compassion. Gratitude is the greatest quality every one of us having. For example, you look at the sun, look at the earth. Billions and billions of years, sun gives radiation, light and warmth to the earth we live. At no time sun has asked earth to thank. At no time sun, the solar system has asked the earth to thank, because I am giving you light and warmth. That is, earth should have gratitude. Earth should have gratitude for 5 billion years.
Hope all of you are inspired and influenced by the great words of this great visionary. So now there are a few questions for you to think yourself. What are the gifts you have received from God? So we are all blessed with innumerable gifts from God. So just take some time to think about the gifts that you have received from God. And the second one is, in what way you can share them with others. So these gifts are not for us alone. We have to share these gifts with others. So how can you share them with others? So these are the questions, and you think about these things. So thank you, dear students, for listening. And keep this in your mind, that this life is a wonderful gift of God. So be thankful to God for this wonderful gift, and also do your best to fulfill the purpose of life on this earth. Thank you.